You can't fool all the people all of the time, but if you fool the right ones, then the rest will fall behind. Tell me who's got control of your mind, your worldview. Is it the news or the movie you taking your girl to? Know what I'm saying? Cause Uncle Sam got a plan. If you examine what they telling us, then you will understand.
Somebody once told me that cash rules everything around me. Now, while it may be true that greed motivates many here in our society, it seems that statement takes on a deeper meaning. Here on the streets of Washington, D.C., the fate of the world is decided in these buildings. In this film, we will go behind the scenes to find out how high the hands of power really do go. In a society where cash is king.
Observe the back of the dollar bill. You will notice the great seal of the United States. This seal has ancient roots and contains mysterious symbology. The reverse of the great seal portrays an unfinished pyramid underneath an all-seeing eye, and is rumored to actually be the symbol of a secret society known as the Illuminati. As you will notice, on the base of the pyramid, in Roman numerals, is the number 1776. This is the same year that the Declaration of Independence was signed. Coincidentally, the Illuminati, meaning holders of the light, was created on May 1st, 1776 by an Adam Weishaupt. Weishaupt claimed to have the true explanation of the mysteries and symbology of another ancient secret organization, the Freemasons. Weishaupt wrote about fire worship and hermetic magic, and he recruited from within the Masonic lodges to form a secret society within a society by promising secret knowledge above and beyond Masonry. It was this secret knowledge that would lead to what Weishaupt called the New World Order.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order, an order in which a credible United Nations can use its peacekeeping role to fulfill the promise and vision of the UN's founders.
The eye in the pyramid began to appear in Masonic symbology in the late 1700s, and in 1785 was already appearing in the United States. Today, it is invisibly visible as logos for corporations and intelligence.
Walk with me. Come on.
It's the congressman and the policeman and the businessman. Would you hand in hand?
Here we are in front of the White House, the home of the executive branch of the United States government. It seems that many of the residents of this building have been Freemasons. But what does it all mean? What role does Freemasonry play in our government?
Needing answers, I seeked out for advice.
Yes, I'm Imam Vernon Fareed. I'm the Imam here of Masjid William Salam, which is located at 614 West 35th Street in the city of Norfolk. In the secret societies, they have meanings for various things. Being a Muslim, our understanding or our position of symbols and signs is based on the Quran, which is the word of God revealed to Muhammad, the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the prayers and the peace be on him. So our final conclusion that we draw from whatever is presented in society as a sign, first of all, it has to have a basis in scripture, in religion. It has to have some connection in order for us to draw a conclusion or reach a decision on the meaning of that sign or that symbol. What I'm saying here is that there are some things that are presented to us from the secular world, from perhaps secret societies, secret organizations, or organizations with secrets, as they would say. And then there are other things that come directly through scripture. They are signs that come to us. They have meaning and connection in religious language.
Traveling through Washington, D.C., I came across this statue directly across from the Supreme Court building. It is a statue of Albert Pike. Some background on Pike. Well, Albert Pike was a brigadier general for the Confederacy in the Civil War. He's the only Confederate general to have his statue in D.C. But he wasn't honored as a general. He was honored as a Freemason. Albert Pike had been given every title in Freemasonry and was known as the Supreme Commander of North America. And while Albert Pike did serve as a Confederate general during the Civil War, he was expelled from the army and indicted on war crimes. He was pardoned, however, by President Andrew Johnson, a fellow Mason. It should be also noted that there is strong evidence that Albert Pike also co-founded the Ku Klux Klan and wrote its doctrines. And it is well known that the Klan held its meetings in Masonic temples. Notice the symbol on the front of the bronzed flag, quite similar, in fact, to our Great Seal. The 33 represents the highest degree in Masonry. There are 32 normal degrees, the 33rd being given for outstanding service. Similarly, there are also 32 feathers on the right wing of our Great Seal. The left wing has 33 feathers. Albert Pike wrote most of the doctrines and rituals practiced by Freemasons. I studied some of his writings, and I found it to be quite interesting. That which we must say to a crowd is, we worship a God, but it is the God that one adores without superstition. To you, Sovereign Grand Inspectors General, we say this, that you may repeat it to the brethren of the 32nd, 31st, and 30th degrees. The Masonic religion should be, by all of us initiates of the high degrees, maintained in the purity of the Luciferian doctrine.
And Mom, what is your perception of who Lucifer is?
Well, Lucifer is a name in scripture of the people of the book. We say people of the book meaning Jews and Christians. Lucifer is a name given there. In our scripture, he's called Shaitan.
Shaitan.
And he is the Satan. He is the big devil.
Who is Lucifer?
Satan. Said literally the bearer of light. And if you can look up either Satan or Lucifer and see references to, I guess you'd have to say, kind of apocryphal and maybe even apocalyptic literature, because there's more said about Satan outside of the Bible than there is in the Bible.
Right.
But the name Lucifer, bearer of light, is a rebellious angel who refused to recognize human beings as truly God's creation.
But there's more. Yes, Lucifer is God. And unfortunately, Adonai is also God. For the eternal law is that there is no light without shade, no beauty without ugliness, no white without black. For the absolute can only exist as two gods, darkness being necessary to the statue and the brake to the locomotive.
Over the centuries, Masons have been accused of worshiping the devil. And that's the first time I've ever heard that somebody who claimed to be a Mason at that level ever say that.
Adonai.
Yeah, it literally means the Lord. That's actually, one would have to say that point of view is very Gnostic. And if you look up the Gnostics, G-N-O-S-T-I-C, you'll see that many of them, particularly the Manichaeans, believe that there are two equal gods vying it out for control of the universe. Other early Christian heretics like Marcion believe that the God of the Old Testament was a lesser god, a demiurge is the phrase he uses, as opposed to the God of the New Testament. Christians, properly so called, have through the centuries always believed that there is but one God, and the God of the Old Testament is the one who is the Father, the Word made flesh, sent into the world, Jesus Christ.
So you would say that these teachings conflict with Christianity?
Oh, sure, without a doubt.
Now I want to take this time to point out that I'm not trying to make the case that all Freemasons are followers of the Luciferian doctrine. However, literature from high-ranking Freemasons tells another story. I tried to visit a few Masonic temples and ask them myself, yet they refused to speak with me on camera or on the subject in general. It may be the case that most Freemasons are just normal, God-fearing people. Yet Albert Pike does say this in his book, Morals and Dogma of Freemasonry. Pike writes, Masonry, like all the religions, all the mysteries, hermeticism, and alchemy, conceals its secrets from all except the adepts and sages, or the elect, and uses false explanations and misinterpretations of its symbols to mislead those who deserve only to be misled. The blue degrees are but the outer court or portico of the temple. Part of the symbols are displayed there to the initiate, but he is intentionally misled by false interpretations. It is not intended that he shall understand them, but it is intended that he shall imagine he understands them. Their true explanation is reserved for the adepts, the princes of Masonry. Is Albert Pike alone in his views? Here is what some other Masonic authors have to say. Some more interesting things about DC. The architect of this great city, a Frenchman hired by George Washington, was, in fact, a Freemason. Pierre Lafont was commissioned by George Washington to design the street layout of Washington, DC. In his design, we find several symbols examining the city from an aerial photo taken from satellite. First, we can see a triangle, which forms a pyramid. If we place the eye on the pyramid, we see that it falls directly on the Supreme Council of Freemasonry 33rd Degree Temple. This temple is located exactly 13 blocks from the White House, as is the case with Albert Pike's statue. A replica of this triangle can be inverted to form a six-point star pointing directly down at the White House. Likewise, if you invert the pyramid on the Great Seal, we have a similar symbol. Each corner on the star pointing to a letter. Which letters? M-A-S-O-N. Now you don't have to be a cheerleader to spell that out. In fact, we can see the same symbol above the eagle, formed by 13 stars. There are actually many instances of 13 in the seal, 13 being a number of Masonic significance. Also noticeable from the aerial view of DC, a symbol that is a little more disturbing.
this force that's happening in the world is coming about all over. It's like resurgent atavism.
It is a role model that I myself am a Satan in the society in which I exist.
We are here, we're not going away, and Christianity and the Day of the Cross are done.
Hail Satan!
Hail Satan!
The age of fire has begun.
One, two, three, four, five.
Sex, sex, sex.
As I mentioned before, the six-point star appears on the seal and in Masonic symbology. It struck me quite odd, as it is a well-known representation for Judaism. Yet, as I researched the occult, the symbol appeared more and more. So I went for clarification.
Well, I think that there's a branch of Judaism called Jewish mysticism. Mm-hmm. And the Hebrew word for something which is received, like a tradition, an occult tradition which is received, mm-hmm. is called Kabbalah. Mm-hmm. From the Hebrew word kibel, meaning he received. Kabbalah, that which is received, tradition. So there is a use of the six-pointed star by some of the masters of that mystical tradition. Mm-hmm. It's not my form of Judaism, but I've read about that.
This unknown mysticism seems to have shown itself again in these rare photographs of the new Israeli Supreme Court building in Jerusalem. We see symbology that is not so subtle. An inverted cross in the courtyard. An Egyptian obelisk that looks awfully like our own Washington Monument. And a pyramid. A pyramid adorned with an all-seeing eye.
Annuis Coeptis, the year of the inception, Novo Ordo Seculorum, of the new order of the world. So they felt as if, almost like the Messiah had come, but not in a traditional sense, mm-hmm. more in a deist sense. Mm-hmm. So I would say they combined the rationalism of the Enlightenment, mm-hmm. but also some of its mystical side. Mm-hmm.
Dajjal,
right.
The false Christ, the Antichrist, that there will be an Antichrist that will rise up. You know, the Christ, we say Isa, the son of Mary, son of Mary in the Quran. He's called Isa, the son of Mary. And he's the Christ, his title, the Christ, peace be on him, a prophet. Sent by Allah, God, and the people who are opposed to what he stood for, in our view, is the Antichrist. Anybody who stands for in opposition to righteousness, because he was a symbol of righteousness. He was also a symbol, according to the Quran, he was a symbol of the Word of God. He's called the Kalimatullah, as you know, in the Quran, and that means that he represents as a figure, as a symbol, the Word of God, and he's given different descriptions in the Quran as a spirit from God, and several other descriptions and titles that he has. You know, all people, even in religion, mm-hmm. all people have been deceived mm-hmm. at one point or another, and many are deceived now. Mm-hmm. They are deceived by the Satan, the devil, the chief devil is the Satan. Satan himself, and he has deceived people in all faiths. That includes Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, and other religions that I don't need to even mention here. He has deceived all, and the light is on now. We have the light. We have the light of the Quran. We have the light of God revealed to Muhammad, the Prophet, prayers and peace be on him. And that's the Quran, and that's what should awaken us to the purity of God's word and the purity of the life that Christ lived. So the Antichrist is not to be perceived as some monster. The Dajjal, that is described in the Hadith, most people come away from that having an idea of it being a monster, you know, of some sort. But it is a monster. Mm-hmm. It's a monster in that it's a symbol or force of unrighteousness.
And it saved our butts. Because the demon wanted to kill us, but he was forced to set us free by the honor code. The demons have to learn to fight, cause it's Satan's surprise and it's magic, and it's a mystical disguise. But the devil, the devil's strong and it's tragic. You mystical-eyed virgin, and you're rocking.
Now, after all that has been presented in this film, what conclusions can we draw from it? Well, that is up for you to decide, because I do not have all the answers. But we must not forget to ask the right questions. For it was Socrates, the father of Western philosophy, who once said, "The answer is in the right questions." Now, some of you may be thinking that this is just another conspiracy theory. And to that, I disagree. Because how could it be a conspiracy when it's right here for everyone to see? Only that it's invisibly visible.
Cash rules everything around me.
This $20 bill, you know, these new $20 bills, the big faces originally started in 1996. You know what I'm saying? So in 1996, we're gonna bring you up to 2001, which is 5 years later. Take this $20 bill, fold it up. Like this? Wow, now. Mr. Bill.
See you. Come back. More pleasure.
Nobody knows anything about it.